Welcome back to Clear Cut. In the U.S., there seems to be growing support for socialism. The unexpected victory of a Democratic Socialist Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez is a prime example. Her defeat of longtime Congressman Joe Crowley in New York's primary election caused both widespread shock and fascination with the movement. Four other women, also Democratic Socialists, won races in the Pennsylvania primary recently. And a recent survey by the American Culture and Faith Institute found that 37% of people 18 and older, that's nearly 4 out of every 10 adults, say that they prefer socialism to capitalism. Let's get more on all of this with Yaron Brook, who joins me now. He is the chairman of the board at the Ayn Rand Institute, a nonprofit think tank that promotes objectivism, amongst other things. Yaron, nice to have you with us.
Nice to be here.
Why are we seeing this rise in socialism?
It is truly bewildering. I mean, socialism has failed everywhere it's been tried. And when I mean fail, not just people get poor, people starve to death, people are murdered, people are killed. Socialism has the blood of over 100 million people.
You look at Venezuela just.
Venezuela is a great example right now. So it's not even history. It's right now in their face. And of course, the socialists always say, well, it's never been tried properly. Next time we'll do it right. The leaders were corrupt. Stalin was a bad guy. But no, the system in and of itself is evil. It is corrupting and corrupt. And yet, that is the big mystery. People seem to be attracted to it in spite of that.
Well, they don't see it as evil. Most of them see it as benevolent and a way of helping their fellow man. Do you think that when we talk about these statistics, that 4 out of 10 adults in the U.S. believe in socialism, that they actually understand what the term socialism is and involves?
No, nobody. I mean, very few people understand. People call Denmark and Sweden socialist, which is a joke. I mean, Karl Marx would be flipping in his grave. Sweden and Denmark are slightly a different form of mixed economy than we are. Look, the whole world today, except for North Korea and a few other places, the whole world is a mixture of capitalist elements and socialist elements. The United States today, we have a vast welfare system. We have huge entitlement. We're not pure capitalism. Denmark and Sweden have a slightly different variation of how much capitalism they have and how much socialism. They're successful to the extent that they're successful because of the capitalist elements. Socialism is what drags them down, just like the US economy, as well as it seems to be doing right now, is being dragged down constantly by the size of government regulations and the socialist elements within our own government.
As Margaret Thatcher would say, the problem with socialism is eventually you run out of other people's money. But this does seem to be a platform that's gaining traction. We mentioned Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez here in the local New York races. But if you look at some of the things that she's campaigning on, free college education, $15 federal minimum wage, expansion of Medicare, universal jobs guarantee, and abolishing ICE, the country's immigration law enforcement agency. Do you see others in the Democratic Party really embracing these kind of positions?
Well, these are all the positions Bernie Sanders took.
And he was very popular. People
were
feeling the burn.
And I think that much of the Democratic Party now is shifting towards Bernie Sanders because he might have won if not for Hillary kind of jiggling, the election. So
reportedly.
But Bernie Sanders was incredibly successful. So I think the Democratic Party is shifting to the left, shifting around these policies. Now, these are policies that basically legitimize massive redistribution of wealth. They legitimize turning the United States into a much larger welfare system than what we have today. I think until we, who believe in capitalism, until we are willing to make the moral case for capitalism and why socialism is not just that it doesn't work economically, but it is wrong. It is evil in that it expects some people to pay for other people.
Well, qualify that and if you could quickly expand on the moral case for capitalism.
Well, the moral case for capitalism is that capitalism is a system of freedom. It's a system that allows individuals to live their lives as they see fit. It is the system that says you're responsible for your own life, for the upside and the downside. If you want help when you're struggling, you don't have a right to pull a gun and force people to help you, which is what the government does. What you have a right to do is ask for help.
Yeah.
And people under capitalism tend to be very benevolent and tell to help their fellow man when, you know, something bad happens to them that's no fault of their own. But look, until we accept personal responsibility, until we accept the idea that the founders had, that this country is based on, that we each own our own life. It's our life to live as we see fit. We're not, we don't belong to the collective. We don't belong to the state. We don't belong to society. Society doesn't get to tell us how to live, what to do, and how we should use our money. We get to decide that for ourselves. That's the moral case for capitalism. It's the idea of America, of individual rights, of the right of every individual to live free.
And yet there's a growing sense of entitlement amongst millennials, not to put the blame on them, but amongst millennials have this feeling that the world owes them.
Look,
why is that? How has the culture changed so much?
I remember Tea Party demonstrations where they would have, limit government, and then the next sign over would be, take your hands off of my Medicare. So the older generations likes their entitlements. Now the younger generation wants their own entitlements. So this is a problem throughout American society. And this is a problem once you institutionalize certain socialist policies like Medicare and Medicaid, like Social Security, things that are very, very popular and people love. But essentially, what is Medicare? Medicare is socialized medicine for old people. If socialized medicine is so good for old people, why doesn't everybody get it, right? So I'm against socialized medicine. And I think if Republicans were really against socialized medicine, they'd have to be against Medicare. So you have to be willing, if you want to take the position of capitalist, you have to be willing to challenge these sacred cows of the middle class and the older generation and not blame everything on the millennials. I think once we institutionalize these entitlements, once we have the mentality that we need to help X number of people, well, why not help everybody? Why not free tuition?
And now, Yaron, it's interesting because you have some of the people that have benefited so much from capitalism, like Elon Musk, Richard Branson, Mark Zuckerberg, calling for universal income. And one of the points that Elon Musk makes is that automation and artificial intelligence is eroding capitalism, that it's going to impact the economy. You see that as an issue, as well as the issue of giant corporations, if you will, snuffing the dream of smaller entrepreneurs. If you look at the pharmaceutical industry, for example, or drugstores, mom and pop drugstores being swallowed by the likes of Walgreens and CVS. How do we now tackle what seems to be these problems emerging in the capitalist market?
Well, I don't see any of those as real problems. Automation is great. AI is fantastic. They increase productivity. They increase wealth. They increase our standard of living. They'll make all our lives better. Do I know what the jobs are going to look like in 20 years? No. But did anybody 20 years ago know what the jobs would be today? No. We've heard these horror stories about the end of work for about 200 years, and it hasn't happened. And I doubt that it's going to happen because human needs are infinite. We always need more stuff. We always want more. And we're going to have to produce that stuff. And some of that stuff is going to be produced by people rather than machines. And all the rest of it, again, the same complaints about big businesses, the same complaints about consolidation have always been around. But I would say that the problem today in capitalism is none of those. The problem in capitalism today is regulations. It's still a distorted tax system. It's ridiculous tariffs. It is, limits on immigration. I mean, we need workers in this country. We've got a massive shortage of workers in this country. They should be expanding legal immigration dramatically in America today, not shrinking it. So there are real problems. All of those problems are caused by government interference.
All right, we will have to have you back to
love to
break that point down further for us, but appreciate it so much, Yaron Brook. Thanks for being with us.